headphones. Sorry, I'm gonna do a quick introduction. Hey, yeah, hello everybody back. Welcome to the second game in the road to the Frankfurt Major here with Team Empire there against Danish Bears. This is of course the second game. I'm guessing together with Llama Down Under, if I'm saying it correctly, I hope so.
Yeah.
Yeah, there we go. Yeah. She's streaming it as well at her Twitch, twitch.tv/LlamaDownUnder, pretty much. So switch over there, stay here, it's all the same to me. That's a fun
game. It's all pretty much the same, we're just having a fun cast here, so I'm probably, this is going to be my last one for now, because I have to take a nap before the America stuff and get some work done, but hopefully you will continue, because I think, I don't want to jinx it for Danish Bears, but I'm pretty sure Empire is going to be the one advancing to that finals.
I hope so as well, because then I can eat dinner.
Always a good way to look at it. Now we've got Queen of Pain Rubik picked up. Rubik's always a really fantastic counter to the Earthshaker, so happy to see this.
Yeah, I just want to see a Rampage again.
I'm really surprised that the Rubik got a Rampage, but yeah, that is a
want me to send you the link?
Yes, I would love to see it. That's so I will watch that later because that sounds fantastic.
Yeah, it's really
now,
fun.
We're going to be seeing Danish Bears. There's a lot of interesting stuff left in the pool. I'm kind of wondering what they'll prioritize. Maybe the Lina that was picked up last time, but I feel like the Doxier is of course banned out. The Wyvern, also a really strong support, who it would be great to get your hands on early.
I don't think they will do that. Yeah, there you go. They're going to go with Skyrath Mage here. Radiant
team. I have really mixed feelings on this hero.
The good thing is that you have this instant silence. Great versus Quad.
But then the bad thing is everything else.
Well, the ultimate, you know, if you can lock somebody down. Yeah, oh, actually, what? They banned it. Okay, I was going to say, you know, if you get some, like, clockwork, but they banned it themselves. This kind of works also against them, so I can understand it. They do have the first pick. No. Empire has the first pick. Okay, I can see why.
So. Oh, yeah, and some folks, the Echo is gone now. He just had to put on his headphones. Don't worry.
Yeah, my bad. Sorry.
No, it's fine. All different casting situations. So either way, SF and Clock banned out. Kind of funny, as you mentioned, to see both of those. The other thing about Skyrath, though, I'm like, his ult is good. I feel like he doesn't bring... He does also have fantastic laning. We can't forget that. He can zone just as one hero. He can zone an offlaner. But it feels like he doesn't scale very well. Things like Glimmer Capes and BKBs just wipe him off the map. So... I'm just not sure about the pickup, even to counter the Qua.
It shows that they want to do something aggressive again, at least. That's the one thing that's for sure. Because Queen of Pain can get up a BKB if she wants to, can get a Yules as well. Orchid, there are many possibilities for Queen of Pain to itemize. Okay, I completely screwed up that word. Anyway, she can get whatever she wants.
Yeah, no, it was close. Itemize.
Yeah, that
sounds
was it.
Good.
Damn it.
Not
bad,
don't worry about it.
I've been guessing way too long today. Anyhow.
So, they're taking ages on this next ban out, and finally it's the Gyro. He had a fantastic game last time, so I understand banning this out, but... I think it makes sense. He's a very strong
carrier.
Hero.
They want to force them to take something maybe that's not normally gets a BKB.
At the same time, you might... Yeah, they can pick up, they can ban the Ember here for Empire, and then immediately pick up the PL. Which is always just a really powerful hero to have if the opponents don't really have a counter.
Ember. Okay, I can see this ban.
Yeah, I feel like they're just gonna pick up PL now. Like, you ban out the PL counter,
yeah,
so...
You're still against Earthshaker. It's not the nicest either. So it's... And Skyrath can be a natural Veil carrier as well. Veil carrier. Anyhow, he can...
Yeah, we haven't seen Veil in competitive games very frequently. It's like a very rarely picked up item.
And if you're Skyrath Mace as well as an Earthshaker, it's more than possible. Both are fairly magical, damage-reliant heroes, so there's no problem with picking it up over there. And against the PL, why not? It just makes it so much easier as well.
I do agree. So, just something we don't undazzle. I like this. I'm a little bit surprised it wasn't the PL. Danish Bears themselves might want to pick up the PL now because, you know, his counter has been taken out of the pool.
And they have the Earthshaker himself. It could definitely work here. He's strong versus Rubik. He's pretty good versus Dazzle as well. And Shadowgrave can be a bit annoying. Queen of Pain, Mana Drain is also extremely nice.
But generally you make enough illusions that the PL doesn't have to worry about the Shadowgrave because he just puts some illusions on you and they keep proccing. But instead they go with the Windrunner. I really think the PL was the pick. And it's a Wraith King.
At least that's the good thing about Wraith King here is that, you know, you have to kill him twice. That's how easy it goes with Shadowgrave
like
as well.
Yeah, I'm just surprised the PL is still ignored. I feel like he becomes an even better pick now.
He has been ignored throughout a lot of the games. His stats gain is being reduced as well as the 0.1 second cast delay or something on the doppelganger now. So
yeah, I think it's 0.35 now, which okay, oh no, one, 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 five, 1.5, 0.15,
okay,
right?
Yeah. Something in a 0.1 something.
Yeah. He can still dodge you before getting doomed, but it is difficult. So, for the PL, more difficult than it used to be. Either way, Wraith King, I like him here also because you have the Dazzle. It just means that he can play very, very aggressively.
Yeah. So. Let's see. Wind range. This is probably going to be the mid wind range. Anti-mage. I think they might just take a book out of the. There you go, Anti-Mage. I was just going to say it's going to be an Anti-Mage or PL. They pick up the Anti-Mage.
Yeah.
It's just going to be a mid wind ranger for sure.
Yep. I think the Anti-Mage, I can't believe my mind just zoned over that. I thought for sure it was banned. I think the Anti-Mage an even better pickup than the PL, just because he naturally steals mana, and also will blow up the Quap, and the Rubik, and the Dazzle, actually. Lots of people gonna be blowing up.
Yeah, you have to watch out now with your mana gain here. This can be completely devastating. Even if you Shadowgrave, let's say the Queen of Pain, no, if she's around zero health, she's probably also going to be around zero mana. So if you still do the ultimate in her, you just kill everybody next to her. So.
Radiant
team bounty ban here from Team Empire. Okay, I don't think they would have picked that one up. That would be really, really weird. That means that you're sacrificing your offlane straight away. You could put the Earthshaker down, but.
I'm really not a fan of offlane Earthshaker, right? It feels like it's very weak in lane, and yeah, he'll get a blink a bit faster and levels a bit faster, but you have a lot of trouble finding those levels.
Yeah, it's just such a hit or miss if he goes in the offlane. Like, it can go amazingly, or it can just go terrible. I was at the resolution earlier today at a game where he was at level 1 at 3 minutes in, so at an offlane Earthshaker, so that didn't go too well. There's Bird, yeah, they saw the games. Actually banning out Broadmoney, yeah, it's just annoying to play against. That's just the biggest thing for Danish Bears here. They, on paper, they have things that are strong against him. But it's still such an annoying hero to deal with as well. It just changed the flow of the game.
Remaining. Yeah. So, reserve time. Be waiting on these lost pickups. I wonder if also Empire, since Wraith King, maybe not. I was thinking maybe if you know you're gonna have that, or if you think it's an offlane Earthshaker, you can pick 212. Run something. That's the 212 that I've normally seen with the slaughter offlane, is that like utility slaughter. He goes 4 stuff. It's really weird, but kind of fantastic. But I don't know if they'll do that here, looking like they probably want, although it would help give them more minus armor with the Dazzle, so.
I haven't seen them run it as well, so I don't think that they would. They could indeed do something like that. There are still one game ahead, so even if they pick something, that might be, in my eyes, a little bit weird to do, because I think that can completely throw them back as well. Because then you. Yeah.
And I don't know. Yeah. I don't know if I've seen Empire do that build. They haven't. Seen a lot of other teams and a lot of CIS teams. Okay. This makes a lot of sense. She locks down. Yeah, if she can get off her duel before you can blink away on the AM because of the cost point. So, nice pickup there. And it will help against the Windrunner too, right? You can blink on her before she gets Windrun off, you duel. Or even if she does, she's held in place, has to take magic damage.
It's good that they have to dazzle themselves. That's all I'm gonna say here, because you're kind of setting yourself up to be jumped upon once you jump on someone as well. At least have the Queen of Pain to jump after you. Wraith King is. All games today I've seen the Wraith King with the blink, so I don't think this will be any different. So at least I have that, but they really need to dazzle this game, and I'm happy they got it. Because this could just blow. They could just blow the Legion Commander up as well. at least for damage pierce. So it's, you don't want to give away damage. The best target. What would be the best target? Yeah, it would be still be Wind Ranger and Anti-Mage. Maybe get a Glimmer Cape up on one of the supports, or just a casual cloak. Haven't seen that one.
And it's a Phoenix. Yeah, I've seen her a bit.
Sorry, be right back. Somebody's knocking on my door.
No worries. The Phoenix is really interesting here. It's a big teamfight ghosty lineup, and she might be okay in the Wraith King lane just because you can dodge the Wraith Fire Blast, but I'm not sure how sustainable this will be. So it all really depends on how the Phoenix does and whether he can get levels. So wow, Maul has a lot of hats. Either way, getting into this, we're going to be going into game two between Empire and Danish Bears. Empire took the first game very, very easily, it seemed like, and hopefully Danish Bears fights back. We've seen Anti-Mages do fantastic things, so I have faith in the Anti-Magoo. 10 seconds remaining. But yeah. So, either way, we're going to be getting right into this. I'm going to introduce Danish Bears again so that our friend can do Empire since he likes the team. We've got Calculus on the Windrunner. We've got Noah being on the Phoenix. We got an interesting effigy right here. Monster Risk on that Earthshaker. Ace on the Anti-Mage with a mop of hair. I don't often get to see Anti-Mages with hair. And finally, the Skywrath Rise to TP'd out to deward them if they came. So... and I don't know if you're back, Sanders. Oh, yeah. tossing it over to you for Empire.
Ugly hair piece at all.
Yeah, it's weird. I've never seen him with hair, like, and this is like a lot of hair, and
I like the new one.
It's a life choice.
The helmet from the compendium looks really, really cool. I want that one. But okay, yeah, here for Empire on the dire side again. I don't know how the hell they did it in the coin toss. Anyhow, we have here on the top lane, let's start from there and move our way down. We have Silent on the Wraith King that gives Alola Dance his signature Rubik. Yoku on the Queen of Pain. That is always going to be played by No Fear, and that leaves Resolution on the bot lane, Negan Commander. That's finally an item on one of Empire's people with actually something in the gem. Most of their gems are pretty empty.
Yeah, I mean, it's not something you normally... do. I don't know how much time they spend on that. Either way, everything's gonna be the normal bounty split, and yeah, just gonna chill. I expect this mid lane to be even, but I actually think Quap will have the edge just because we saw Yoki played a little bit better than Calculus last game. Yeah, I was trying to remember his name.
Yeah, well, so. You're playing against a veteran player, so it's somebody has been to TIs and things. Yeah, you have to watch out a bit.
Yep. And suddenly, Calculus already taking a bit. That's the Shadow Strike for you, right? You can Windrun, it doesn't matter. You take Shadow Strike damage. Actually taking a huge amount of damage. Right clicks, holding a lot from the Quap.
Yeah, they have the exact same items. The only difference is that Calculus had the health potion in the upper right slot.
Now, they're actually playing really aggressively on this bot lane. I'm kind of surprised by this. I didn't expect, Empire is. I expected the Radiant to be aggressive, but Empire being really aggressive. They got that Dazzle backing up Resolution. Another cold, press the attack. Sorry, overwhelming odds. And just gonna auto-attack. Oh, gosh. Did you see how low Skywrath got there?
Yeah, that was really, really close to the edge there.
Dazzle went first spell Poison Touch.
That's not something you see often.
They want to kill. It got a slight change in the last... Oh, the heal bomb also ace.
Yeah, the funny spell shield like, doesn't even help if you get it.
It's pretty rude. It's like... I like this type of aggro. You don't get any farm lane, but it's also really painful to be in as a support. So...
Yeah, in the meantime, this is just how you need to play against an anti-mage, though. You need to pressure him.
Yeah. Exactly.
Even if you lose some mana here, you can see they have a stick, they have an enchanted mango. Somebody watched some of the Merlini's clips, I guess.
Yeah. Now, Dazzle isn't going to get the bounty, that is going to go to Ryzed. He's still level 1 though, he's just got this Arcane Bolt, but he's going to take a Poison Touch to the face. They're probably just going to auto-attack each other a little bit. And we have a pause.
By the Earthshaker on top. Was he the one who always had issues?
He's been having issues.
Okay, it was him. Okay, well... Keep on having issues. Oh, yeah.
Happens to the best of us, though. Like, we don't actually get to choose when the lag happens as much as we'd like to, maybe. So.
I guess a choice would be never then?
I don't know whether it would be never. It probably would be, though.
Yeah, it seems a logical option. You can already see the Legion Commander. I want to make a walk-in, but already stopped it.
Nay. So either way, Skyrath, while he is getting very low, he's not going to be dead. I think he just has to go back to base, though, and this actually makes the anti-mage suffer quite a bit, right? He can't be as aggressive, or any really aggressive at all, when the Dazzle gets back to lane.
Yeah, that's it. I don't think they can kill him anyway.
Legion Commander has a lot more lost hits, though. He's burning her mana so she can't use that overwhelming odds, but you still have to be careful in this bottom lane.
She hasn't had chance to mango, like, she's just all playing on Ace Gunning low. And they're just throwing everything on her and just killing her off. Or killing him off. He did get a PMS in the beginning, which is a smart pickup.
Yeah, but of course it doesn't save you from that overwhelming odds. And
pick up some magic stick straight away. Empty soul lane.
Fox also, she wasn't winning the lane for a little bit there, but now she's come back and she's pretty much dominating it. She somehow got up from 7 and 3 up to 15 and 9. So, Calculus losing out not only on lost hits, but on a lot of experience. And I think that's gonna make it makes the lane a real pain.
So.
Anyway, they're going in on Silent up top. He, of course, is only level 3. Phoenix looking for a kill with the help of the Fissure, but not gonna find it.
Okay, Yokido in mid is going aggressive on Calculus. Will Calculus die from this? I think he's gonna get close now. He will survive.
No, with 30, he needed one more tick. Yeah, it was almost gonna be the 1 HP.
I thought it was gonna be 2 more ticks.
The Legion Commander still has this bloody mango, so, like, every time, as you pointed out, Ace gets low, he has to be really careful.
That's what they're playing for. They're just waiting for him to get low enough, pop the Tango and kill. The mango. Yeah, they do this all the time on Empire. They always have a mango. I think Silent has one as well without looking. Okay, he has none. That's weird. He will get one.
The saving grace is that they did force the Wraith King back home. So now he has to wait a little bit. Oh gosh, Dazzle got that deny there. That's painful. So it's like something where both teams are having their safe laners have a bit of trouble. They're actually aggressively going in on the Dazzle, the immediate shallow grave. He's going to try to walk it off, but he's not getting out of this. I'm a little bit surprised. This is going to be our first blood, slow and steady.
He wanted to TP. there is to it. He stood still to do the TP, but
and
he
then
miscalculated.
Lost too much mana.
Yeah, mana break level 2. Usually she just level 1 mana breaks.
Since that's another thing Ace is doing. He has no points in spell shield. I feel like 1 point would actually help him against this overwhelming odds, but I think he's all Wraith King gets.
Double
kill.
Okay, what? Okay.
We missed the first one because it was going down at the same time as the first blood.
DP in. A lower dance has to an instant lift here. There we go. But yeah, he might still
die.
Can
he throw a fire spirit? Oh, he dodges it. Oh, he's going to take a...
What?
Oh my goodness. He dodged the Icarus dive completely. And he did not have balls on cooldown or did not feel like using them. So Rubik gets away.
I'm really amazed. As a Phoenix, you might as well go balls deep on that one. It's a level 4 Rubik, so at worst here, you're going to get an easy trade.
Yeah, I don't know if he wanted to give up another kill to Silent. Oh, holy cow, look at Silent dodging these fire spirits. And actually now, the Phoenix is very low, though Silent has no more mana, so maybe they could get another fire spirit on him. They do, but they would need more. These fire spirits only level 2. The Icarus dive is going to be up, but Phoenix deciding not to go for it. In the meantime, down bottom, some shenanigans down here too. I think he finally got a point in spell shield. I was going to say, I think you need one as anti-mage, even though a lot of Dazzle's damage is magical.
Mostly physical. Shadow Wave is the damage healer.
Sorry, yeah, that's what I meant. Sorry, even though most of it is physical, I think you still need a point of spell shield. Because of the overwhelming odds.
Yeah, he needs to make sure that Resolution gets down to low mana again. Thing is, he can't really walk up to him. He's not going to win this fight.
And Dazzle will heal bomb him as well, if he does, in a lot of situations. So, Resolution getting denies under tower, also always painful.
Yeah.
So, in the meantime, switching over to net worth, we can see that while the anti-mage is above... Actually, I'm a bit surprised he is above the Wraith King, even though the Wraith King got the double kill.
I think the Wraith King died. Oh, yeah.
He had
to go back
to base.
Yeah, it's pretty much equivalent to dying. Maybe even worse. Takes longer.
At early game, it is worse because of the respawn timers, and I don't think he had much gold to lose.
So it takes longer, so that's just essentially all there is to it. But it's not that big. Ace is not really farmed at all. So I think he has to get his boots and still stick. Just get a stick. If he would have had this, if he had a stick, he would have had so many charges already.
Yeah.
So weird.
He also is only 22 lost hits in at 7 minutes, right? He is having a rough time.
Yeah, let's see. On his lane so far, have been 17 denies. Since No Fear has 5 as well. Let's see. Now 13 on resolution, so. They're just sucking.
Anyway, they're going down again. They killed off the Phoenix with that rotation, and now they're also going to catch Calculus. She does have the wind run, but that doesn't save you from Fade Bolt, so.
Maybe the commitment would have been better there if she just turned around and tried to get a power shot on a lower dance and just try to get a return kill.
I think it's one of those issues as well where folks tried to do a rotation, but the Queen of Pain coming up there as well. When you rotate your mid, you always want to have the numbers advantage, and they didn't. Meanwhile, the net worth and experience.
A lower dance on top. He's gonna burn out. But did get off the nice lift here. Phoenix needs to run away, but there is already a rotation.
She can pop the egg. I'm actually really surprised she didn't just egg there. In comes Windrunner. They couldn't get a shackle. I think if you can get a shackle there, you just egg and hope it kills him. Because even though egg, you know, you want to use it for a good team fight, but 8 minutes in, just use it. The cooldown's only 110? Yeah, 110. So.
She could do that indeed. You might. Yeah, you have to go to second life. With Thresh Fishing, he would have enough mana to respawn. But even then, there are not enough TPs to go to. Queen of
Pain, and it's 260 seconds. It's one of those things where I think you're okay using that cooldown at 260 seconds. Aloha Dance, though, poking his head around bottom, looking for the anti-mage lift. Whew. Ace actually almost blunk onto him, I think purely by accident, so.
Is it actually the best dance worth? Blunk? The blink?
I use it. I'm pretty sure it is. A lot of Americans.
I don't know. I just
wonder. I'm Australian, so I speak the Queen's English, so it must be right.
I'm Dutch. So. What kind of English do I speak?
You probably also speak Queen's English.
I guess.
You're near to Britain. It's only Americans. Yeah, okay. They speak this really weird shit. Americans.
I'm close to UK.
So. Anyway, Quap, she's being gone on by Skywrath, but I think Skywrath in a lot of trouble, but now Quap, they don't have enough of a monopoid to do anything, though he actually uses the monopoid, he needs to blink off to her, but his blink cooldown, oh, so long, and while you might have saved the Skywrath, you would have loved to get the Queen of Pain there, you know?
Yeah, the Queen of Pain actually tried to get off the Sonic Wave there, but it's really got cancelled and then just blinked out, like, okay, I give up. I'm not gonna try.
Yeah, I think if she stayed, she would have gone down.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
But in the meantime, they got bottom tower, so still really good for Empire again. They're getting up to that 5k net worth lead. It's not GG, but it's really rough.
They've just been showing that they're so strong in the early game against any team so far.
Like, and it's especially painful with these heroes, right? Phoenix needs levels.
They got levels. Level 6.
He's level 6, but it's 10 minutes in, you know? Your safe lane farmer, higher level, Aloha Dance is gonna find Ace, and Ace is lifted. I don't know between the two of them if they can do anything. Quap thinking about coming in, Ace wants to go ham, but... I can't believe he stole Mana Void and not the Blink, but yeah, Ace hasn't used it since, apparently. Quap now thinking of coming in, there's the Shallow Grave, the Focus Fire is going off, and there's the TP, and he doesn't have the Mana Void! The Fissure slightly off the mark, and Quap just gonna blink away. Can they get anything done here? There is a duel up on Legion Commander. No, everybody's just backing out. Nobody wants to engage. Legion almost has her blink as well.
Yeah, once the blink is up, it's gonna be a little bit harder. Just, let's see, Ryze is level 6. It's still a nice target to go after. Maybe kill Master Ring at level 4 a couple of times. Just 700 HP. Should be an easy one. Just has a mango in the inventory. Oh, he has been shit-faced. Okay, he's gonna get something now.
Yeah. So... the other issue with the blink up is Anti-Mage has abandoned the Battle Fury, at least for now. I think he's going a Yasha just to help him farm more. And that means that his farm isn't going to be coming online with the timing. I think, unfortunately, on Anti-Mage, you have to go the Battle Fury. It's core to the hero.
Against Wraith King, you might actually be able to pull off the Manta first.
I just think you don't have the farm to get your other items at a good timing without the Blads or the... You don't necessarily need the Blads, but I feel like you definitely need the Battle Fury. The Blads is nice.
I'm still wondering if it's the Man of Elf skin is not for threats.
Oh, yeah, it could just be his charge as well. That means he's even further behind on this Battle Fury. They're trying to do something onto Legion Commander. She needs to be careful here. She's very close to the blink. She wants to make sure she gets it, so...
She doesn't have to be too scared. With the Dazzle behind her and Rubick now as well, and so she'll be okay. Yeah.
And what's probably going to happen here is Danish Bears will try to go and overextend, although they actually just saw everyone, so they will not overextend since they saw Aloha Dance and no fear.
They
might try to go
impressive.
On Aloha Dance. He does have that Mana Void, let's see what he can do with it. He does use the Fade Bolt, there is no, the blink away, he steals the blink!
Yeah, that's the one
And
he
now
wants.
They need to, yeah.
Level 1 Mana
I heard someone
useless.
Need a Mango. Oh, Legion Commander has the blink flying
yeah,
after her?
Yeah, she used the Mango to get the storage off of the blink. That's all there is to it.
I thought maybe she wanted some, something, but no. Phoenix is suddenly level 8, he's been getting a good time up in top. If he could kill off Silent again, even just to waste the 260 second cooldown, it's powerful, but not looking like he's gonna go for that. So this team fight in the middle though, Sonic Wave coming out, Windrunner taking a lot of damage, but they managed to get a lot onto the Queen of Pain as well. Windrunner finally going down, taking a lot of damage from that Rubick who blinks away. The Arcane Bolt gonna follow him, but... Yeah, no return kills for Danish Bears lineup. And again, it's these little pickoffs, but they're falling further and further behind as well because the Wraith King is just free-foaming.
Yeah, essentially somewhere down the line it's going to be troublesome. That said, Wraith King has absolutely no farming tools. A blade mill is not an item that helps you.
I'm used to him going Midas just because you don't have anything to kind of AoE clear. You don't have any spells that do AoE damage, you know? So, used him going the Midas to accelerate his farm and levels, of course. Wraith King, another hero who wants the levels.
I've actually not seen a Wraith King Midas in the entire open qualifier. All went actually
no,
this build, all went blade mill into blink.
Yeah, I haven't seen it in the open qualifiers. I see it very commonly in other leagues, and that's why I'm a bit surprised. I don't know whether it was there was a patch change that changed it, because I think...
Midas is still more than viable. He just needs to get aggressive now to use his blade mill, because otherwise he might as well get a Midas.
Yep, they have the smoke. Let's see if they can make it latch. No, he goes all the way under tower. I don't think they saw the smoke. I think Skywrath Rai is just feeling like something was off.
Yeah, they don't see anybody apart from Silent Farming, who the thing that he's pretty much doing only. This is really how Empire always plays. They just go aggressive with four heroes and Silent is just doing whatever. And he joins in about 20 minutes or something.
Yeah, he farms a lot, and he joins when he's good and ready. He's very much a, yeah, I'll be there when I be there team. Carry on without me. I've also seen Resolution do it in a few of their games, although maybe we'll see something here. Quap is gonna find the Earthshaker. She's just, oh, she's invisible, so she's not gonna open yet. But here she comes. She could just bloody Sonic Wave and kill both of them, but it's on cooldown. A Shackle Shot of Dreams. Resolution isn't gonna be able to get the dual damage, but he is healing himself up. There is the egg. They destroyed the egg. They're also gonna pick up the Earthshaker on the back lines. Power Shot doing nothing. They finally get the Legion Commander. In comes Andy Mage, not doing enough damage. There's the Shallow Grave. Silent is like, I'm ready to fight. I got second life. And they're gonna use the Wraith Fire Blast on Ryze. The Power Shot way off the mark on Calculus. Finally does get no fear, but now running against everyone. Blink away from Rubick, doesn't manage to make the Shackle land, and boom! They finally do get the Rubick, but I don't know if this guy's getting out alive. Ace? Maybe he can juke? Oh! Did they have a board up there? No, they just could see him in those positioning. I thought maybe he could juke them around the,
He was 5 seconds off his blink.
Yeah.
That's not gonna work. Level 1 blink is... Yeah, it's a nice idea to go into stats to be farming faster, but you need more points in blink. You don't want to give the better blink to Rubick, but still, it's... Okay, level 2 now, but still, it's not enough.
I do feel like because of how far behind he does need to do the stats build, though, right? Because he's not...
He's already going back for more potion blinks. He's actually going for the Battle Fury still, just a random band of Elven skin. To help him farm, I guess.
No, I think it is for the shoes, but then he suddenly got a lot of gold and a couple kills, so he bought the claymore, you know? You know that feeling, you're like, oh, I suddenly have 2k gold. We have an engagement up top, though. What was stolen? Just the power shot.
Nothing big.
So it is max level, so Rubick can hit this. Calculus has been having a lot of trouble getting a good one off. But You know, I think it's also... Oh, gosh, the Fisher off the log, and now Silent going on the back lines onto Ryze. He does have a second level in that respawn, and they haven't popped it. Phoenix needs to Icarus dive away. He gets it. A long-ranged Wraith Fire Blast. Phoenix has the egg. Oh, but gets power-shotted!
Rubik, although they're just showing the snipe off here, and they're not gonna stop here. Blink forward from Silent, and Messerisk, he's gonna die here. They're gonna look for more. Are they able to find Calculus here? He's already fairly far. They will have to dive fairly deep here, but the Weave came off, but yeah, Windrun is popped, and they're gonna just give it up and take a tower. That's Constellation.
Yeah, and he gets hit by the power shot and is unable to hit anyone in return with it. It's really hard. So... and now they're at a 10,000 net worth lead, and it's going to be a 10,000 experience lead. This is probably actually a 15,000 net worth lead, you know, when everything settles down, and with the two towers they're going to get. Maybe only one tower if they can mount a defense, but Earthshaker isn't even level 6.
Yeah, he can do Fissure and walk back to base. He doesn't even have enough mana to get
both. And Queen of Pain in the bottom. Oh, they're going to finally kill off Yoki. They TP'd in supports. They get a huge bounty for Yoki. So, you know,
That's a 1600 gold swing.
More. It's 1800 when you add it all up. Sorry, they gained some gold as well. I misread that. So only 1500, but oh gosh, we've got an engagement onto the Windrunner. This isn't gonna work, I don't think. Calculus should be able to run it away. I completely missed where Earthshaker went down, but now Ryze is here. Maybe they can do something here. Do they have the Shackle of Dreams in 7 seconds? She doesn't get it though. But no, I think they have it with the slows. Where are the balls? The balls could come out. They don't even need them with the concussive shots. Or do they? No, they do finally get the kill. So.
A really good play here actually by Ryze, just waiting for the Thresia attack to be used. And then concussive shot, just so he can get the slow on him afterwards, so he doesn't dispel it.
Yeah. And while Empire is dominating this game, I wanted to say, folks, don't discount out Danish Bears, right? They've obviously made it this far. They're a good team. They're just stacked up against a team who should have been invited and only wasn't because they shuffled their roster. Not invited, but should have been invited to qualifiers.
Yeah, at least that, so. Yeah. This is... so. Yeah, a lot of teams have been dumpster truck buddies. Like, they just completely destroy them. They actually had one perfect game, and then you're like, how the hell do you even win a game with zero deaths?
Yeah, they had the, like, 0-54 game, right?
Not 54, I think that's MFF. Or maybe Liamondox or something.
Yeah, so it had been rough for folks having to face up against Empire. Now, looking at some quick item pickups, we've got Arcane Boots on the Dazzle, we've got the Orchid up on Quap. To me, the Orchid up on the Quap is the most devastating, because now she can pick up anyone. You can definitely blow up Windrunner before the... before she
Windrun?
Gets off the Windrun. Thank you. I was just like, what is this spell name? And it's her name. It's so embarrassing to forget the one that's her name.
She still has a 4-step, so I don't think the target is the Windranger. The target is everybody apart from the Windrun.
AM, Phoenix, none of them have any way out, so.
Yeah. Even the Earthshaker is okay. Echo Storm can
almost... He almost has his Battle Fury, though. I mean, I know it's late, but he's still a hero. We've seen him take over games before.
Yeah, but this is not going to be one of these games, I think. Because just a Battle Fury is not going to be enough. Like, he needs a Manta now, and he needs it now, because there's an Orchid. He's going to tell it at least 4 times before he gets it.
We have probably what's an engagement. Everybody's trying to TP out. Can he get the TP out? I think he can. Yes, he can. What? Oh my goodness.
I heard the sound.
I did too, and it's on cooldown.
What? Resolution is also like, what is that? Oh my god.
It's on cooldown. No, that's why Resolution is freaking out, because he knows it's on cooldown and Danish Bears don't. Getting back into serious time, we have got the Blade Mail strat. We have Blade Mails on Wraith King and on Legion Commander. It's considered a bit of an early game item, but it does make it really hard. Oh, it's Yoku. Okay. Oh, apparently his name is Yoku, not Yoku.
Yeah, Yoku with an
Oops.
You. Yeah, I also
but
say Yoku.
It's spelled with a Y.
Yeah, I know. It's really weird. It's Russian.
And they pick up Windrunner just like that. Stolen power shot again being used to blow up the Windrunner. So I will keep saying Yoku. So,
yeah, keep on trying that. These Russian names are sometimes really, really hard. Lisa's the only one that's like that.
Yeah. So we're going to have a quick pause. I'm going to pull up the items just so we can have a look around. We are 3 blinks. We're rocking the blinks and the blade mail strats. Rubik just needs to go one, and then we'll have another blade mail to join in. We also have the Orchid That we talked about a little bit already. She, of course, is holding the Aegis. Dazzle is poor, but you expect that someone has to be the sacked support, and it hasn't been Rubik this game.
Queen is also getting the BKB now.
Yeah, and Risk has been having issues all day with his ping.
All day? Or just this match?
I don't know. I think all day. I'm actually always impressed when these teams who have ping issues win their games. Like, I just feel like it's a little bit harder to win your game. Now, Phoenix, yeah, did you just mention he has a Midas?
No, I let the items go into you. I just said the BKB for Queen.
Yeah. So I think this Midas, he's still really far behind, but it's a good start. If there's any hope of winning this for Balkan, for Danish bears.
Yeah,
because I used to cast Balkan bears. I used to cast them back in Dota League, so that's why I get the name. No, they actually had a team, they used the wrong tag. One of the new teams uses the Balkan Bears tag in a lot of their games, even though it's not them. Either way, Yoku maybe a little bit out of position. Resolution hitting the Shackle of Dreams, he is gonna maybe go down. There's the Phoenix Egg though, and because of the shallow grave, he's okay. Skyrath's picked up in the back lines, but they do manage to get Resolution, and this Egg, it's not gonna explode on anyone. Here comes the Queen of Pain though, using that BKB Sonic Wave, just blowing up Windranger. She can't stand against these things. And now Ace, he's taking a lot of damage. There's the lift, he doesn't have the blink. Now it's only the Phoenix. There's a beautiful Echo Slam taking so much damage on the Blade Mail, and that's a five-man team right.
Yeah, there was an Echo Slam on a Blade Mail target and a BKB. It looks nice, it's what he had to try and do, but it was just a bit too fast for level. This is just gonna be harder and harder.
It's probably a tier 3 tower. I don't think it's Rax quite yet, just because of the restorm timers. But it's already a 20,000 net worth lead when that team fight settles down.
They still have an Aegis.
Looking...
I think she goes aggressive. Yeah, here you go. Alodan's going forward first. They're going to follow it up now.
Alodan might die here. He might be punished. No, he's going to just walk it off with the urn charges. Oh my goodness. This is really hard. They're definitely losing the tower. Phoenix also
gonna try
doesn't have egg.
They're going to try it
They'll probably go for ranged.
Maybe Alodan will now blink in instead with the item and not the actual skill. Might be better.
So, Silent, oh goodness, Calculus just trying to man fight this, but there's the Telekinesis using up all of that Windrun timing, and they have damage, they have magical damage, Calculus, you have to get out, they finally blow up Aloha Dance, but Calculus goes down again, AM left to defend in their base, but Silent is there, and he still has the Resurrection, he has Omelette on as well, hitting like a truck, he doesn't even care if he goes down here, right, he's not gonna die, Shackle doesn't latch, and Silent
that's
just
nice
kind of walks off.
We must say this before anything else happens, Resolution 0 dual damage.
Yeah, he hasn't made. Oh goodness, there's the aggressive blink forwards. Windrunner gonna take a Wraithfire Blast to the face. They need to just like do something about Silent. While Resolution might be zero dual damage, we have an 8-0 Silent, and he pops the egg really far away from them. I think it needed to be a little bit further forwards, but not wanting to be too close. The egg does explode, so at least he gets that off. But now they don't have any follow up with the egg down, and. Oh, Quap links in again aggressively. Is she gonna blow up Windrunner? Windrunner force stomps away everything to try and get out of there, taking a Wraithfire blow to the face as well. Power shot coming through. They need more of these Phoenix balls on people, I think.
Yoku wants to die. 50 seconds left, or maybe a little bit less now on the Aegis.
In the meantime, though, Silent not going down at all. So much healing. And there's the duel. Will this be the first dual damage of the game? The stun out on Resolution,
yes!
But his teammates follow it or follow it up. And yeah, that is your dual damage.
Honor saved. Honor saved. That's all there is to say to it.
I mean, it's 24 minutes in. We've seen before where folks don't.
But that's still bad.
Yeah,
there's no excuse. As a Legion commander, there's no excuse to be at 25 minutes and have zero dual damage. Even this is fairly poorly, to be honest. Like, you should probably more play around it. It's just that they don't have to play around it, that it doesn't matter that much. They just have so many things around it.
Either way, they've got a lane of Rax, and AM, yeah, he's rocking the Battle Fury, working on a Vlad's, not feeling like it's enough to defend. What's
even
our buyback status? Yeah, only the AM and the Quap have the buybacks, so Danish Bears, they have to play this really carefully. And there's a lot of options for Empire, right? They can just wait for the next Roche.
Yeah, if they want to, but it's Empire. I think they don't go aggressive as they find someone here.
Oh,
damage.
They
there
do!
You go.
Oh. Phoenix immediately buys back, owns that up while farming that creep wave, is gonna have the egg up shortly.
Assault.
So there is an egg defense, but it's still level 1 egg. She needs like two more, she needs one creep. She needs three experience.
Okay, this is
Oh, the aggressive blink in, they think silent can't die. He does have, holy cow, he has an AC. When did that come online? Of course,
just
you pick up because of the racks. Yeah, it's one of those things where you get a lot of gold. Three balls flying out all at once. Maybe they're going to get something, but I hear Queen of Pain doing stuff elsewhere. And she
misses.
Sonic waves and misses, and she doesn't actually have the ags yet, so that's going to be on cooldown for ages. The Rod of Aphos coming out onto Aloha Dance, really confused the Phoenix with that item. A nice Echo Slam, and again, two Blade Mails returning all of the damage to the Earthshaker, and that is not how you wanted to play this. We've finally got to knock out one life of the Wraith King, but that's one life. We have so many buybacks, Ace Sport back as well.
Yeah, I'm just waiting for the items to be delivered now. Yoku can almost get his side of fives now. There is already a flash ready for Nova here in the base, so. And just a nice Shepard shot returning and straight into the duel here. They're gonna blow up Calculus here as well. There's an Agony backline. For now, they're ignoring it. Are they able to destroy this in time? Yes, they are.
Yeah, completely.
No,
too many of them around, and he didn't hit balls on any of them.
Nice Fissure here, but it doesn't matter as Yoku just goes after him, kills him as well. Fissure is also stolen. Are they gonna look here for more? Ace tries to go out, gets a Fissure thrown in his face. They don't have enough damage to just kill him instantly. He will get out, but still so
I imagine the GG calls have to be coming soon, right?
Nah, they don't want to give up. It's the, you know, it's your tournament life. It's not a league or anything. If they lose this game, they're out. So you gotta keep on until they're gonna hit your creation down. Until then, keep on trying. You have late game, maybe. If you're lucky. That's
yeah,
it.
Unfortunately, with everybody dead, it's really hard to do anything. Anti-Mage does get a kill on the backlines on Dazzle, but now he's gonna be dual damage, and that's the GG call.
Okay, that was it.
Yeah. Either way, this is gonna be it for me. This was Empire versus Danish Bears. Still a good fight from Danish Bears. Really well played from Empire, though. So that's, I need to go do a few things and take a nap before the Americas get started. And either way, it's been really exciting. I've enjoyed casting these mages, and it was fun to cast with you. Nice to meet you, Sanders. Glad that we just met up in the lobby and decided to cast.
Yeah, it was fun.
So, yeah. So I'm gonna be out. Peace out, folks.
Yeah, see y'all later. Well, that was Llama Down Under, and well, there was the second match for Team Empire here against Danish Bears. They won this one as well. Their road to Frankfurt is very, very real. They're just one best of three away from actually going to the qualifiers now. Let's just stick around. I'm gonna restart Dota so I get that stupid sound bug out. And that was it. Enjoy the music, and we'll see you guys soon again.